what's this happening to you? It don't matter if it's happening how you want it to happen. I remember one of the occupants said that at a point. The Most High, He'll send you. He'll send you an answer to your prayers, but it may not be how you expected it to be doing. And that's why this is written right here. Because it's not going to always happen how you want it to happen, but this is what you're asking for. So look, you're going to roll with how the Most High set it up, or you're going to continue how you've been doing. That's the end solution to the whole process, man. If you want to continue because your mind is, I expect the Lord to send you a virtuous woman. He might not send you a woman, a virtuous woman. He might send you one that's there to take care of you. You know what I'm saying? Things don't happen how you always expect it, man. But does that mean doubt the Lord? No, man. That means continue and see what He's doing for you, because everybody's life is different.
But the Lord will always, the Lord will send you a virtuous woman, or He might send you according to your spirit. You know what I'm saying? So if the Lord send you an evil woman, it's according to your spirit. You know, now what the brother meant was basically, you know, send me a big booty bitch, and the Most High might send you a woman that got a good mind on about herself, or she might be a woman that's, you know, a good woman that's financially stable, or that's, you might see a beautiful woman that don't got a job, but it's something that you need, you know, to help you get along. It's not the complete woman that you need, again, in the scriptures, because a complete woman is, she's beautiful, she listens, you know what I'm saying, she's obedient, she's a keep at home, she can cook, blah, blah, blah. You know what I'm saying? It might be not every single aspect, but what helps you get, you know, what helps you stop you from fucking up, being a adulterer or a fornicator, which is adultery. You know, fornication is adultery, you know what I'm saying? It stops you from doing all that madness. You know what I'm saying? Somebody just holds you down. You might just be a beautiful woman that got no problem with you being in the truth, that got a good sex game, and just, you know, you just work and do everything else, and she just, you know what I'm saying, and it just keep you where you need to be, you know. But he ain't gonna see you no fucking nigga woman, you know what I'm saying, like type of girl, she's a fucking headache type of thing, you know. And virtuous is, it means righteous, you know.
So, James chapter 1 and verse 9, it says, let the brother of low degree rejoice in that he is exalted, but the rich is that he is made, in the rich that he is made low, because as the flower of the grass he shall pass away. For the sun is no sooner risen but the burning heat, but it withereth with grass. So like it withers the grass, and the flower thereof falleth, and the grace of the fashion of it perish. So also the rich man fade away in his way.
Yeah, hey, because that goes into what? Hey, like the Lord spoke to the rich man, right? Like, hey, you cannot make it into the kingdom, man. You know, it's like, well, you know the law statute, you know, do this. Like, man, I do all of that. Good, man, huh? You gotta give away all your riches, huh? Say what? You know what I'm saying? That was something he couldn't handle. But that was his level of testing, man. His level of temptation, so to speak. All right? That was something he had to sacrifice in order to... He asked a question. All right?
He didn't want that answer like the brother said.
That's what I was saying. He asked the question, but it came in a different answer in a way he didn't want. So what did he do? He ignored it, man. All right? That's why the Lord said it's easier for a camel to go to the eye of a needle than for a rich man to inherit the kingdom, man. All right? Because people, yes, money is good and it's a defense. All right? But the love of money is evil. That's the root of evil. All right? Because if you got that love of money, you wasn't going to do whatever to get it, man. All right? Look at the entertainers and the things that we know that they've done. All right? Homosexuality acts, right, the sacrifices. it's not about, you know, it's not gonna come down to having money. Okay? You can't buy your way into the kingdom of heaven. Alright? That's why it said, what did it say about the lowly man being exalted and then the rich man being low? You know? Because that's playing the other side of the field. Alright? I'm fire on offense, but how are you on defense? Like, you know? What do you do for defense?
The blessed is the man that endureth temptation, for when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord hath promised to them that love him.
Yeah, blessed is the man that endures temptation and fight through it, push through it, man. Alright? That's how you receive that crown when you've been tried in that trial, man. By enduring it, by overcoming it. Alright? Not just being in the fire, in the midst of the fires. Woo-hoo! Like, no, you gotta push through that. It goes to 2nd Ezra, the 7th chapter. Alright, if the man don't go through that gate, how can he inherit on what's on the other side? Alright? Man, I don't know about that bridge. That mud kind of narrow. I see water over here. I see fire on this side. Oh, man. Yeah.
Cross the bridge because you see the fire.
It's not like the Lord said you got to have one rollerblade and go. Like he just said, cross that path. Basically, go through it, man. You're not just going to have the kingdom given to you. You're going to have to work for it. All right? To actually have to work for it. Just like them some of them women, you ain't getting in, you know, that 90-day rule. Some women got 90-day rules and shit, you know? You gotta be around and for 3 months before, but then that's what it is. So some of them, get it on the first night, like, whoa, you know? That's what you don't want, man. With the Lord, that's what you're gonna have to endure. You're gonna have to wait. Alright? The Lord's not gonna come on your time. He's gonna come on his time. Because that's the best time to come. Obviously, if that's the time that he set for him to show up, then show out. Alright? And give salvation to the elect. Okay? Then obviously that was the best time.
Says, let no man.
See her on the side.
Says, let no man when he is tempted. Let no man say when he is tempted, I am tempted of the Most High. For the Most High cannot be tempted with evil.
Yeah.
Neither tempted he any man.
Yeah, and basically he's not gonna tempt you to do the wrong thing, all right? That's why you have a left-hand side, you got a right-hand side. The left-hand side do what the left-hand side is supposed to do, all right? Which Satan showed you that. Man, what's up, man? I'm just been going up and down, you know, to and fro here, you know? Hey, go try out Job. Man, no, I don't wanna mess with Job. You got somebody else. You know what I'm saying? Job is cool with you, you know? But that's Satan's job, is for him to bring those temptations, man. Satan got a job just as much as you do. Hey, a brother had a video.
The Lord don't initiate for you to do evil, basically.
Yeah.
You know, the opportunity is there. But once you start doing evil, then you're open to whatever spirits that the Lord sends on you. You know, because if you notice from Saul was doing evil first. And then the Lord sent the evil spirit upon him. We're like, Saul doing good, I'm about to fuck him up. I'm about to see, you know what I'm saying? Like, Job was doing good, and the Lord let Satan fuck with him, but he said he can't take his soul. So he lets Saul lose his wits, his spiritual righteousness, man. You know, but Saul, he allowed a demon to get on Saul, man. You know? He actually sent it because Saul was open to him. It says in the same chapter that you're overthrown by your own lust and what you want, so what you're open to. You know? That's why the scripture says when you get rid of those spirits, you're supposed to clean that house, man. You know? Don't leave yourself open to anything. You know?
reading on, it says, for the Most High cannot be tempted with evil, neither tempted he any man. But every man is tempted when he is driven away of his own lust and enticed.
Every man is, what it said, every man is tempted when he is driven away with his own lust and enticed. All right, meaning it got egged on, so to speak. You know what I'm saying? You play with fire, basically. All right? You basically play with fire, so that, like the brother just said, that you opened up to it. All right? You opened yourself up to it. You clean that house, and then you move back in because you miss how it looks. Man, I used to be on the porch, you know, watching the cars go by. You miss how that feeling that you felt, man. But at the end of the day, that was a sacrifice for your benefit. Because that was part of that old man. Those old demons is part of that old man. All right, now they're going to come back stronger and more. But at that time, if you know what you're supposed to be doing, you'll be stronger. All right, you'll have more faith to overcome them. Okay? They're like, man, let's keep moving, keep on moving. Every time we find where he live at, keep on moving. That's what you're supposed to do, just to keep on moving, man. All right, like it tells you in 1 Corinthians 9:24, man.
It was just like the scripture we was reading the other day, in Sirach, where it says, be not confident in the plain way.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because you could be doing something on a regular, and you're like, okay, this is working for me, it's righteous, you know what I'm saying? But then it comes to a point where Satan figured out that plan way too.
Yeah.
So you gotta be prepared to be like, okay, this ain't working no more. You see things start going bad or whatever, something, things start changing. You gotta adapt.
You really gotta be cautious at everything. You know, cause adapting is after the bad thing happens. You know, it's like driving and not looking both ways. Right? Driving and not looking both ways, then when you come out, somebody flies out from nowhere, you've been fucked up already. Now you gotta adapt. But being confident, don't be confident in playing ways, no matter how many times that nobody comes, you don't see them, you still look both ways and you make sure your shit is on point to where somebody come out from nowhere, you can see him like, man, if I would have been looking, I would have got hit. Or I would have had to, you know, adapt and hit a move on some shit. You know, why you gotta do all that? When all you gotta do, instead of being confident in playing weight, just like you spar somebody, jabbing like this, because they suck. Just like it works on everybody, you know what I'm saying? So you put a fight somebody and that person just fainting and hit you, bang. You ain't got no, you gonna eat that. You might can adapt, but you don't want to adapt being dizzy as fuck. You know? You don't want to adapt when the car's right here. You don't want to have to adapt in the heat of the moment. So being confident, don't be confident in playing ways, basically. So know the basics. Stick to the basics. When you become teachers, you ain't need a note. Go back to the basics. Keep your foundation structured. You know what I'm saying? At work, Morbi told me, man, like every like once a month, like at nursing homes, they say, hey man, you know, the city's coming in. When the city coming in, they're checking everything. They're checking how clean, how sanitary, and throw this away where you put the sharps at, how you use this and do that, and how the patients carry it, they ask everybody questions and shit like that. And everybody panicking, everybody trying to tighten up. And Asian's like, man, he sat me to the side like, if you just do everything right all the time, you wouldn't have to tighten up. You wouldn't have to worry about if you're doing your job right. You know what I'm saying? So don't be confident in playing weight. Nobody, city never shows up. And then a week later, the city's coming up next week. You'll be like, oh, shit, I gotta clean this whole motherfucker up. You know? That's what the Lord say. What? You know, when he comes as leaving the night, the workman that he finds so doing, as long as you're doing your work, as long as you're doing what you're supposed to do with consistency, he's like, okay, you know, the Lord pop up, oh shit,
you know, while you cleaning up in the middle of doing your regular routine. You know what I'm saying? Instead of being like looking outside to see if you're coming, then you see the lights. And you trying to hurry everything. You ain't got time. You trying to shove clothes under the bed and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? That's a death. You know? The Lord come and shove this other bed, put this in the closet. Try to pause. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Hey, come on in. You know what I'm saying? Then fucking shit just pour out on him. Like, what the fuck is this? That shit nasty, man. You ain't doing nothing. You know? So you want to be. Not confident, I mean, to be confident or not confident in a plain way is basically staying on your toes. And the way you stay on your toes is keep your foundation very structured. Don't go to doing fantastic shit. Like I was talking to somebody about lifting weights and all this, and they said, man, I want to lose weight. I said, you got to do high intensity and work it out. I said, calisthenics. Nah, but I'm going to lift weights and do all this.